Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to yet another video. Did you know that the fastest way to top Google search is through Google Shopping Ads? In this video, you're going to find out how to make your clients happy and their revenue sky high by setting up a Google Shopping Ads account and using it correctly. And here's everything you need to know.
This video is brought to you by TamWeb, an automated WordPress platform powered by Google Cloud specifically designed for agencies. Sign up for our 14-day free trial right now and experience the true innovation.
But before we start, let me just remind you to hit that red subscribe button below to get regular tips and updates about growing your agency revenue. So let's discuss all the reasons why the clients of your agency, especially online shops, should use Google Shopping Ads. The first and the most important reason is that it's the quickest and easiest way to get to top of Google search. Reason number two is that it's eye-catching and contains all the essential information about your product or service. It can be an image, the price, or even reviews. So it's pretty effective. And finally, the reviews are super easy to integrate and they're such a good way to boost your CTR. So how should you set up Google Shopping Ads for your agency? Step number one is creating a merchant account. Here's how. Sign into your agency's Google account. Then activate the Merchant Center. Now you gotta type in the name and website of your agency, add the location and a time zone. Also, let's click on my website and hit I agree to the terms of service. Great, now let's hit continue and verify your website with Google Tag Manager. I've already put the tag to my website. Then you have to create a product feed. Click products here, then create product feed. And now you need to set your location and language, as we don't want to show the ad to people who don't know the language of the ad, right? After that, you should pick a name of your feed and choose how you'll be importing your product or service info. You can choose Google Sheets template or just make your own spreadsheet. Now that you have your product feed ready, let's add the attributes to our product. The ID number can often be the SKU of the product. Then we add a title, for example, skirt, and we write down a description, maybe the size and the material of the product, and a little bit about its use. After that, we link it to our product's landing page. We can write about the condition of the product, whether it's new or old. We can write down the price. And also we can mention if the product is available or not. We can also link the image of our product. And also you can delete the GTN if your product is not an innovation. And finally, MPN is just a random number of your product. You can just pick any number and write it down. Next, you may want to classify your product. You can find the category of your product on Google Product Categories. I'll put the link down below. And finally, you write in the name and you're all done. Also, there is a new option, website crawling, which is a pretty simple and
automatic way of uploading your products to Google Merchant account. The third step is creating your Google Shopping campaign. For that, you first need to get an AdWords account or log into yours and link it to your Google Merchant Center. You'll get the notification on your Google Ads account to approved Merchant Center linking. After you've linked the two accounts, you can create a campaign from your Google Ads Manager. Click Create Shopping Campaign, type in the name of the campaign, the country of the sale, and the daily budget. Choose your campaign type, like shopping gear and country. And finally, you get to pick a campaign subtype. Usually people pick standard campaigns because they're more customizable. Then you can continue setting up your campaign through Google AdWords. Once you're done with setting up your campaign, go ahead and pick your bidding strategy, aka payment method. For example, you can choose to pick what you're willing to pay for a click manually or let Google automate that and maximize clicks. The next step is setting your monthly budget. You can choose the standard option, which will distribute the budget evenly, recommended for beginners, or the accelerated option, which will spend your budget faster. Once you're done with campaign setup, it's time to choose your ad groups. Essentially, ad groups are used to separate different products, brand names, and categories. It's essentially useful if you want to showcase a collection or a line of similar products or products that go well together. Creating ad groups is simple. Just pick a name for the group and add the products that belong into it.
I bet setting up your first campaign took you quite a lot of time. Luckily, you can rest as your campaign is waiting to be approved by Google. And when it is approved, the campaign enters the learning phase, which means that Google is learning more information about your agency by gathering data later to analyze your conversions. And this means that your campaign is live. Okay, but how should you generate lots and lots of revenue for your client when using shopping ads? Well, you have to optimize your agency campaigns, and here is all the steps you need to take. Retargeting list search ads. This is all about going after the visitors who have already visited your client's website or their old customers. It's usually more effective to go after warm audiences. To target these groups, first you have to start a remarketing list by starting a remarketing tag on your site. Once you got the production IDs from the Merchant Center feed, you can generate a dynamic ads with that info. Just go to shared library, choose audiences, click new audience, and choose remarketing list. The next one is automated rules and scripts, which are rules that are applied only if certain criteria are met. For example, you can choose to set up a rule to pause campaigns if CTL is below a certain number.
To create a new rule, log into your Google Ads account, go to your campaigns page, click the three dots on your campaign menu, and click Create an automated rule. Then you have to pick the type of rule you want to apply. Pause or enable campaign, change an email, or change budgets. You also have to set the condition here. In this case, say if we want to pause it if the CTR is below 0.5% per 1,000 impressions, we need to click on Add, set CTR to 0.5%, then click Add again and set impressions to more than 1,000. If we want to check for this rule daily, we also have to go to the frequency section and choose daily. Name the rule, save it, and you're done. Now your campaign will automatically pause if the CTR is less than 0.5%.
Another thing you can do to optimize your campaign is to make sure that your product feed is precise and concise. Try to keep the descriptions clean and simple, and let the product speak for itself. And also make sure that you categorize a product correctly and try to anticipate what potential buyers would like to know and provide that info. A good description is about 500 to 1,000 characters. Keywords, as you know, are key for Google. And that's why optimizing your campaign requires you to add CTR increasing keywords. What are those? Well, messaging that gets your potential customers excited. Things like free shipping, money back guarantee, limited offer, and etc. etc. If you find yourself at loss and don't know where to start, you can use SpyFu to spy on the keywords your direct competitors are using and include them as well.
To check your performance report, just log into your Google Ads account, go to Campaigns, and pick the campaign you're monitoring. Then choose an ad group in the campaign, click product groups on the left here, and there it is, a table with all the info about your campaign. CTRs, conversion rates, impressions. Tracking and analyzing your agency's campaign performance will make sure you're moving in the right direction.
You'll be glad to know that Google Ads has plenty of tracking options, so monitoring your campaign's daily data won't be a problem. There are pretty simple rules that make sure the images of your product and service work well. Always make sure that the images are large, at least 800 by 800 pixels. It works best if your product is set against a white background and makes around 75 to 90% of the image. Or you can showcase your product in use to inspire potential buyers to imagine having your product. It's also cool to make use of the additional image link option and pick up to 10 images for a product or service. It's also another way to gain the trust of the audience. Google provides plenty of tools for bidding optimization, and the most helpful ones are the Bid Simulator. This tool helps you to answer all your what-if questions using the data your campaigns have given to Google. So if you ever wonder what will happen if you increase your bid, use the simulator to find it out. Another one is First Page Bid Estimates. If you've ever wondered what it would cost you to show up in the Google search's first page, this is the perfect tool for you. And recommendations page. Use this page to get recommendations on improving the performance of your agency campaigns. All right, now that you know how to set up shopping ads and optimize your campaigns, it's only a matter of time before your Google search rankings soar. But don't be discouraged if the first campaign doesn't bring you great results, as it's only a matter of trial and error and data monitoring. Hope you found this guide helpful. For more quality content on managing an agency as efficiently as possible, make sure to hit that subscribe button below. And of course, likes, shares, and comments are appreciated. Take care, and I'll see you in another video.